Hello students, today we will study the excretory unit of our excretory system, that is nephron. We will study the structure of nephron. As you can see in this diagram which I have drawn, this is a long convoluted tubule like structure. This nephron actually divided into two parts. In higher classes you will study that two parts may be called as this part which is cup shaped, this part, starting part of the nephron is called as Malpighian capsules, and this convoluted tubule system is called as renal tubule. But I will tell you which are the labels you have to learn according to your 10th class. In this, we will study what are the parts of the nephron, starting from here, cup shaped and this tube like structure, right, and ends here. First, I will show you how, where these excretory units, nephrons, are located exactly in the kidney. Take a look of the magnified view of the kidney. This I have drawn one of the kidney. This is the concave side of the kidney, right? And this is the convex side of the kidney. This kidney is actually divided internally in few pyramid-like structures. And I am going to tell you where the nephrons or the excretory units are present in this kidney. These nephrons are actually present like this. This is convoluted tubule-like structures, and that and end here. You know, students, about 1 million of nephrons are approximately present in each kidney. You can imagine that how much surface area it will provide for the excretion. These nephron tubules are present like this. Millions of nephrons are present, and their end part, tubular part, is going to collect in one common duct. When it is going to collect in one common duct, and then it is extended towards the ureter. I have told you in the previous video also that the nephron structure, function of nephron or the excretory unit function is to excrete out or to separate out the waste from the blood. Blood will remain in the body, but waste is collected by these nephrons, and all the million of nephrons collect this waste from the blood and transport it to the ureters. And from the ureter, it is going to collect into the urinary, store in the urinary bladder in the form of urine, and then ejected out through the urethra. Now I will explain you the detailed structure of the nephron. Now let us study the diagram of the nephron. Carefully, students, that this is the cup shaped part of the nephron, which is called as Bowman's capsule, after the name of the scientist. Now this Bowman's capsule extends towards the tubular like structure, which is called as proximal convoluted tubule. In short, we can say it is PCT. Right? Next is, tubule extend downwards, and this tube is called as descending limb. And then its diameter decreases when it extends downwards, and this is called as Hennel's loop, after the name of scientist again. Hennel's loop. And then it again extend to upwards, called as ascending limb. Next tube, last tubular part of the nephron, is called as the distal convoluted tubule. In short, we can write it as DCT. And then there is a common duct like structure, which is known as collecting tubule or collecting duct. Right? Now I will explain you the role of collecting duct. As you can see, there are these some branches which are not drawn, which are left. These branches are the continuation part of other nephrons. So many of the nephrons are connected together with one collecting duct or one tubule, and then it drain all this waste into the ureter. Right. First of all, students, you have to learn these common and important part of the nephron, that is the Bowman's capsule, cup shaped, proximal convoluted tubule, descending limb, ascending limb, distal convoluted tubule, and the collecting tubule or duct. Okay. Now, after the label of these parts of nephron, look here. As you know, from the aorta, oxygenated blood and impure blood, which is with the toxic waste material, through renal artery it enter into the each and every kidney. But renal artery again can divided into many of the small arteries, which is called as, or small capillaries through the renal arteries which are coming, which is called as afferent arteriole. These capillary structures which are originated from the renal artery, and these afferent arterioles now come at the junction of each and every nephron. When these afferent arteriole at the junction of each Bowman capsule, it form a network of capillaries which is named as glomerulus capillaries. Glomerulus capillaries, right? Now this is also one of the important label of the structure of nephron that you have to learn. Let us discuss the important steps of urine formation. There are three major steps of urine formation. First is ultrafiltration, which takes place at the junction of glomerulus capillaries and Bowman's capsule, in which the toxic waste is filtered from the blood into the tubules of nephron. Second is selective reabsorption. Selective reabsorption means the absorption of those substances which are very important for the body, and this takes place in the tubular part of the nephron. Third is tubular secretion, which means that secretion of toxic waste material through the nephrons, through the tubular part of nephron. That's why it is called as tubular secretion. Now, I will explain all these three steps with the help of diagram. Now, in this diagram, as you can see, this is a renal artery which enter into left and right kidney both. And from the renal artery, the small capillaries which arise from it, that is afferent arteriole, which brings the oxygenated blood and the blood which contains toxic waste in this. This blood, through the thin capillaries, when blood is circulated in the thin capillaries, glomerulus capillaries, from here, the substances which are having the small molecular size or small molecular weight, they diffuse from the glomerulus capillaries into the Bowman's capsule and make the filtrate. Now, what are these substances which enter from the blood into the Bowman's capsule? That is the glucose. You can write here as glucose. Please note down, students, glucose, amino acids, salts, urea, which is obviously a toxic waste, and large amount of water enter from the blood capillaries, diffuse from these glomerulus capillaries into the Bowman's capsule. So this is the first step of urine formation. So I have written as first to help you out, that this is the first step called as ultrafiltration. Now, the substances which are present in the blood, but their size is too high or they are having large molecular weight, they remain behind in the efferent arteriole, that is into the blood. That is the proteins, and proteins plus blood cells remain, WBCs, RBCs, platelets, their molecular size is large. So, they remain behind in the blood, which is the important component of the blood body too. And these circulate with the blood in the efferent arteriole, right? Next, this is the one of the process. Next, come back to the first process. After the first process, what happens to these components which make the filtrate in the Bowman's capsule? They move forward into the nephron tubules. First part of the nephron tubule called as PCT or proximal convoluted tubule. From here it extend downwards into the descending limb. But there is one more process which is called as selective reabsorption. With the help of it, the important components which are circulated in these tubules, such as what are the important components which flow with the toxic waste in the nephron tubules, that is the glucose. Very important, not going to be waste. or excreted out amino acids, some salts and huge amount of water. Students, please note down huge amount of water. These substances are very important and not to be going to excreted out from the body. So these substances reabsorbed back into the blood capillaries. Right? These substances are again reabsorbed by the blood capillaries. So we will indicate this step as second step called as selective reabsorption. That is the reabsorption of selective substances. And how or where they are selectively reabsorbed in these blood capillaries which are the extended part of the efferent arteriole, encircle all these tubular region, surround all these tubular region, and then join back with the renal arteriole. With the renal venule, which contains blood plus the important substances such as glucose is there, plus amino acids are there, and the huge amount of water is also present in this renal venule. And from the renal venule, these are entered into the renal vein, and through the renal vein it transported back to the vena cava, and then from vena cava back to the heart. Now come back to the second step, where the selective reabsorption of important substances takes place from the nephron tubule into the blood capillaries. Then what happens next? What remain in the nephron tubules now? In the nephron tubules, there remain some amount of water is there, some amount of salt is there, some amount of and huge amount of urea or toxic waste, which is also called as nitrogenous waste, left in the nephrons, nephron tubules now. Now this extend forward in ascending limb and then move towards the distal convoluted tubule, that is the DCT, and then enter into the collecting duct. Through the collecting duct, which contains the what is present in this last part of the nephron tubules, that is the nitrogenous waste, which is urea, plus some amount of water is there. This form urine, and this will connect with the collecting tubule, and collecting tubule connected with the ureter, and ureter will connect it finally into the urinary bladder. So this will form the last part of the last process of the nephron tubule, will form the third step. Third step, which we have discussed, third step is called as the tubular secretion. Now it is clear to you, students, these are the three steps which we have discussed in this diagram. First step is, let's recap. First step is ultrafiltration. Filtration of blood takes place at the junction of glomerulus capillaries and the Bowman's capsule. From here, small substances, small molecular substances, glucose, amino acids, salts, urea, water, filter, and will make the filtrate. Move forward into the convoluted tubules. And from here, the important substances, which is not going to be waste, as glucose, amino acid, huge amount of water is again reabsorbed by the blood through the efferent arterioles, blood capillaries, and then rejoined back with the renal vein. Next, the left amount nitrogenous waste, which is left in these tubules, excreted out through the collecting duct into the ureter. And the third process, third step, which takes part in the DCT and collecting duct, is called as tubular secretion. This is the third step which I have marked. Okay, in this way, urine formation takes place. Now, do you know, students, about 1100 to 1200 ml of blood is filtered by the kidneys per minute. Okay, this is the fact, student, that this much amount of blood is filtered by the kidneys per minute. That means per day 180 liters of filtrate is formed by each kidney. That means this much amount of, this directly means that this much amount of filtrate is going to form our urine. But do you know only 1.5 liter only 1.5 liter of urine is released per day by the humans. How it can be possible? That means 99% of the filtered, where does it goes? Do you imagine? Do you understand this concept again? That is, this 1100 to 1200 ml of blood is filtered by the kidneys per minute, which forms 180 liters of filtrate per day. But we are releasing only 1.5 liter of urine per day. That means 99% of the filtrate is reabsorbed by the kidney, by the nephron tubules, which is the second step of urine formation, called as selective reabsorption. That means this huge amount of water is reabsorbed back into the body, so it reduces the amount of urine from 180 liters to the 1.5 liters. Some more important points I have to discuss with you. As you know, kidney's function is excretion and osmoregulation. How the osmoregulation is regulated by our body, that is, the posterior pituitary gland is there in the brain. It releases one of the hormone which is very important, called as ADH, antidiuretic hormone. The role of this ADH is to increase the reabsorption of water from the nephron tubules. Reabsorption of water, that means huge amount of water reabsorbed back into the body and less amount of urine is going to excreted out. But you have to know, students, that there are several factors which affect the activity of ADH. Several factors, as during the, when the person taking drugs, when the person taking alcohol at that time, during stress, during trauma, during surgery, or when the anesthesia is given to the person, at that time it suppress the activity of ADH. When the activity of ADH is suppressed, then what will happen? Reabsorption of water will decrease and the person will excrete out the high amount of urine. That means dilution of urine takes place at that time. Okay, you know, kidneys are the vital organs for us, for the survival. There are several factors such as infection and injury, or there are several factors which restricted the blood flow in the kidneys, reduce the activity of kidneys, and this will accumulate the poisonous waste or toxic waste inside the body, which is very harmful to us and which will also lead to death. So that means during the kidney failure, in the case of kidney failure, in this kidney failure, we can an artificial kidney, or it is also called hemodialysis, can be used. It is a type of device which is used to filter our blood and remove the nitrogenous waste products from the blood through dialysis. When the person has to go, there are two options in the case of kidney failure. One is the artificial kidney and other is the kidney transplantation. But transplantation is, we can say, it is the costly process and it is not easily affordable by all. So by the help of dialysis or by the help of artificial kidney, which is a kind of device, a person has to go to the hospital for the 3-4 days per week for filtration of his blood through this device. This device is, it also works on the basis of the kidney nephrons, excretory units, that this device is also remove out the nitrogenous waste from the blood of the patient, and which is connected with the renal artery, and then the pure blood is given back into the renal vein. Right, students? So you have to make a short note on this. This is your homework, that you have to make a short note on artificial kidney and hemodialysis. Write 2-3 points about it. Right. Next is, at last of this chapter, the last topic is, which you also have to, I have denoted as your homework. It is, you have to make some points, and I will summarize this topic in short. That is excretion in plants. Excretion in plants. Plants utilize a different kind of strategy to deal with the excretory products. Such as, what are the excretory products? We have to understand one by one. That is, excess of water is excreted out from the plants by the help of transpiration. Yes, as I have told you, in the transportation in plants, when we have studied that, about 98 to 99% of water is going to be excreted out in the form of transpiration by through the stomata. Next is excretory product. Oxygen is also acting as the excretory product, which is released from the photosynthesis. CO2 is also acting as excretory product, which is released during the respiration. We can say by photosynthesis and respiration, these two gases are released through the stomata. Third is dead parts of the plant, such as leaves or other parts of the plants, may fall off. This is also one of the strategy to excrete out all these dead parts, all these waste products from the plant body. Fourth is resins and gums, which are stored in the vacuoles of old xylem. They are also excreted out from the bark of the tree. So this is also acting as the excretory products. This is all about the chapter of life processes. Students, please make all the notes properly. I will provide you all the notes on the groups, and update yourself. Thank you.